Hi guys and welcome to Total Technic. In this video we're going to show you how to retrofit the ISOFIX child seat bracket for your Audi. This video is relevant for the majority of Audi models, so let's get stuck in. So the first thing we're going to need to do obviously is to lift up your rear seat bench. As you can see, we've already done that for this video. I've already filmed a couple of videos for different models on how to remove your rear seat bench. So if you're unsure on how to do that, most of them come out in exactly the same way. So I'll add some links for you below this video. So go down and check that out and get your rear seat bench removed, and then we can move forward from that stage. So once you've removed your rear seat bench, what you'll end up with is something like this. And obviously the ISOFIX bracket is no longer present. And this is exactly what you'll see when you lift your rear seat bench up. However, the important thing to point out is, although your car won't have been fitted with an ISOFIX bracket from the factory, they all come with the holes pre-drilled into the chassis. This is for the vast majority of Audi models. I can't think of one offhand that doesn't. But you should have the mounting holes here ready to fit the ISOFIX bracket into. So these will come from the factory even if your car was never fitted with the ISOFIX to begin with, which is why a retrofit is nice and easy. So that's something to bear in mind. So next we look at the bracket that we're going to fit into these holes. Okay, so you've got to get the correct ISOFIX bracket for your car. There are a few different variants for different models. For example, the Audi A4 ones are different to these particular ones, which are on the RS6, which is the C5 platform that we're working on today. So you've got to first find out what the particular one to fit your particular car is and ensure that you get the correct one. And once you've got that, you've also got to make sure that you get the pair of the correct fixing bolts. That's these right here. Very, very important you get the correct ones. Obviously, this is a safety-related item. These aren't very expensive from Audi. I don't know the price offhand, but I know they're not silly money. So it may well be worth, even if you manage to get, you know, say a second-hand pair of brackets, if they don't come with the bolts, it would be worth going to your local Audi, spending a few pounds to make sure you get the proper bolts rather than trying to cobble it together with something that you might already have lying around at home. So that's something to bear in mind. That's literally all you need is the bracket itself and the two bolts. And obviously, if you're repeating that on the other side, you're going to need another bracket and another two bolts. So with that in mind, let's look at how to put this together. Now, with regards to the fixing bolts, one of the important things which is often overlooked on these is you should put some nut lock on these. This is to help prevent them from rattling free, which is, to be honest, unlikely. But again, as it's a safety related item, these should have some nut lock to ensure that they stay fixed. Quickly, with regards to a nut lock, some people call it different things depending on what brand. You get nut lock and thread lock as a general rule of thumb. Thread lock is permanent, tends to be red, although again that can vary depending on the brand. A nut lock is like a semi-permanent, that tends to be blue. Like I said, that is a little bit of a rule of thumb. So what I've got is I've got a little bit of nut lock here. Now what you'll find when you buy these brand new, these have never had nut lock on them even from the factory. You see there's no trace of a blue on there at all. When you buy these brand new from Audi nowadays, it'll come with a little bit of a dried nut lock on it. It'll have like a blue circle on the side of it, and so you may not have to do this. But let's assume that you do have to do it. All you want is literally a dot that big. That's more than enough, and that'll work its way around the thread when we come to fit this. But very, very important part of the retrofit on these ISOFIX. So then all we're going to do at this stage is just put them both in and just start them off finger tight. Actually going quite a long way. So what we're going to do is get both of these finger tight down as far as you can, and then obviously we'll swap to the wrench. Tightened up there, so we need to swap to the wrench and we'll start tightening these up to the next stage. I'm just going to get those so that they're lightly tightened. Then what we're going to do is we're going to tighten it up with the torque wrench to the correct factory spec. Okay, so I've swapped to the torque wrench now. So we're going to tighten these up to 30 newton meters, which is the correct factory spec torque as per Audi Workshop software. Like so. Yeah, spot on. Spot on. So if you don't have a torque wrench handy, they're kind of you kind of got to do it so it feels fairly tight. You're not hanging off of the wrench to try and keep going. It's 30 newton meters is not a massive amount. So don't over tighten them, but they do have to be secured. Again, that's where the nut lock's going to come in as well. Once these are safely in place, that nut lock's going to prevent these from rattling free in the future. So that's it, guys. That is how to retrofit your ISOFIX bracket. I hope you've enjoyed the video. Be sure to subscribe to our channel and have a look for lots of other great Audi videos. Thanks for watching. We'll see you on the next one. Thank you.